bhavap varga bhamato jada bhavet chanas satarhi ochyuta sat samagamah satsangam jarhi tadaiva sadgato paravareshetai jayate rati bhavap varga bhamato jada bhavet chanas satarhi ochyuta sat samagamah satsangam jarhi tadaiva sadgato paravareshetai jayate rati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told actually Agasur, Bakasur, those demons they primarily they wanted to prove that we are very friendly with Krishna. Primarily, they wanted to prove, first of all, we are very friendly with Krishna, we have come to play with Krishna, to help him. But ultimately it was proved by their activities, they are actually demons. They are not at all personal associates of Krishna. Very important thing. Many demons, they are coming in the guise of friends to help Guru Varga, Krishna and Guru Varga. But ultimately their activity, by their activity, we can detect very easily, they are actually demon. Very important thing. Yesterday, time was very limited. I wanted to speak so many things. You can remember you are speaking that preaching can be done both way. Preaching can be done both way. One is negative way, another is positive way. Negative preaching is very fast. Rapid preaching can be done. But result is very poor, very bad. And effective preaching, positive preaching can only be done by a great devotee. Actually, what do you mean by preaching? What do you mean by preaching? To inculcate bhakti siddhanta into the heart of any bonded soul. What do you mean by preaching? Preaching means to inculcate bhakti bhava into your heart. If preaching procedure is only, you know, some kirtan, some prasadam, then no use. If you have no bhakti, you cannot give bhakti to others. What you don't have with you, you cannot give it to anybody. First of all, you should have bhakti, tremendous bhakti, not ordinary bhakti. Ordinary bhakti means mixed bhakti, not pure bhakti. Pure devotion is rare, you know. In Chaitanya Charitamrita you can find one nice word. Krishna Shakti Bina Nahi Bhakti Pavartan. In Bengali, Krishna Shakti Bina Nahi Bhakti Pavartan. If Krishna Shakti is not there with you, you have no power to preach bhakti. Money power, manpower is not sufficient so that you can go and preach very easily. You can go to America or say anywhere you can go as you like because you have money power. But that doesn't mean that you are an effective preacher. In South India, you see, in South India trip, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going in whole South India, there you find one Bipra Brahman, whom Chaitanya Mahaprabhu blessed him, he was very eagerful to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, no, you go back. It is my blessing to you, you go and speak all about bhakti. You try to speak about bhakti, my blessing is there with you. My blessing is there, my power is there. Blessing means power. Shakti. Guru Bhargava, when giving me blessing, that means through blessing is giving some power to me, which is not possible for me, then now it is possible for me because Guru Maharaj giving me kripa. It's possible now. Then that devotee, I mean, by the blessing of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, now you go, Amar Agai Guru Hoya Taroye Des. You go to village to village and try to speak all about bhakti and try to deliver all those bonded souls. It was a special instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not a matter of joke. You cannot speak that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told 500 years back, 550 years back, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it is my instruction, you go and act as a guru. Not that. Some sahajya can speak like that, but Siddhant is not that. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was doing Leela, that time that situation was special situation. Eligibility is big factor. But still, that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so free to distribute prema, even those creepers and beast and everybody got kripa. Patra patro vicharanam na kurute na sa param vikshate. Deya deyo bhimarsaka na hi nova kalo pratiksha prabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not thinking that he is not eligible, he is not eligible, he is eligible, not thinking that. Patra patto vicharanam na kurute. He is fit, he is qualified to take my bhakti. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not speaking like that. Simply he is distributing. If you have no pot, like somebody want to give me some milk, then I need pot. Without pot, how he can give milk? But at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if there is no pot, I mean, you are not eligible to take that kripa, bhakti. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, if you, okay, no. Okay, it's not a matter. If you have no pot, I can give you pot. At the same time, I can give you nectar. Pot and nectar I can give, provide you. Then no problem. That was the very, very unique, situation was that time. Actually, without bhajan, you cannot get prema bhakti. Sometime in market you can find sell 50% deduction. If you buy in the month of Baisakh, I mean March and April, you can get some sort of extra, deduction. That was a special situation when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here. That time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to give prema to everybody. That was a special situation. But if you want to get that kind of prema now, not possible. Everybody is speaking this point from Kirtan. Nabhojityo dai premdhan. They are projecting this point. Maharaj, we heard Nabhojityo dai premdhan. Without bhajan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving prema. I mean, you are foolish. Actually, not. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself told, with Rai Ramananda, discussion going on in Kabul, South India, that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spoke in front of Rai Ramananda. Saddha vastu sajan bina keho nahi pai, kipa kori kaho rai paibaru pai. In Bengali, you must read Chaitanya the purport, translation, you must know, otherwise you cannot reach up to that feeling. It's a big problem. There it is written that Mahaprabhu speaking in front of Raya Ramananda, Shaddha Vastu, after sadhan, after doing strong sadhan, what you are going to get, that is, you should have one goal in front of you. If you don't have any goal in front of you, simply you are like a vagabond, you are moving around, no use. In your school life also, you should have one goal. In college life, school life, education life, you should have one goal in your life from childhood, you should have. Without goal, nobody can come out successful. Aimless man cannot come out successful. So when you started bhajan, I think you must have one goal in front of you. Of course, if you are misled, then I have no responsibility. If you follow our Guru Varga properly, then I would say like that. You have one goal. That goal, you see, what is that goal? You are doing bhajan to get Krishna prema. Prem dhan bina, bartho daridra jivan, das kori, betan more, deho prem dhan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, "O Krishna, make me your servant. I don't need salary, monthly salary, money. I need only prema. That is my salary. I like to be your servant." He is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Krishna, but still giving this argument so that we can understand. I like to be your servant, but in lieu, in return, I want only salary. What salary? Money? Dollar? No. I want to get prema. Prema is my, you know, salary. Can you give? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu praying in front of Krishna so that I can learn. He is Krishna, you see. So you have one goal, I think so. Shaddha vastu sadhan bina keho nahi pai. If you are going to get that prema, that is as far as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Siddhanta, Gaudiya Siddhanta, prema is the ultimate goal. So that to reach that prema, to get that prema, you are doing bhajan. Your bhajan is, if your bhajan is perfect under the guidance of all Guru Varga, perfect, then you are surely going to get. If your target is far, okay, but your procedure is not good, then there is no surety that you can come. There is no surety, you can come out successful. So, Nabajito Dai Prem Dhan, without Bhajan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu get Prema, that time it was possible. Situation. But now, without bhajan, sadhu sadhan lila tahate nakore hela, Nartomadhagu speaking. Sadhu sadhan, the procedure, you should not ignore. You should not ignore it. Be careful. This way, now point is that, the Prabhupada wanted to preach all over this world, and all our Guru Varga, they came in front of Prabhupada. Like Srila Goswami Maharaj ji, Srila Bhaktivinod Thakur Maharaj, all our Guru Varga, you see, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Sridhara Goswami Maharaj, they are unique in nature. Prabhupada giving kippah to everybody, and they are doing all nice preaching all over the world. The speciality of Goswami Maharaj, if I want to speak in front of you, it will take months. It's not possible. I like to give some example through which you can understand what I mean to say. I want to glorify. It is already glorified by Krishna. So I cannot speak this way. Who am I to glorify is? He is already glorified by Prabhupada, Bhaktivinod Thakur and Guru Varga. I mean Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is glorified. Nitya Parshad. Is Goswami Maharaj, Madhu Goswami Maharaj, they are all our Guru Pad Padma, the Bhakti Pamat Puri, they are all eternal Parshad of Prabhupada. This Siddhanta I wanted to speak in front of all public yesterday. The who is Parshad? Eternal Parshad, what do you mean by Parshad? one point you know, when you are doing, praying, you see, bandana, si chaitanya manavhishta sthapitam jena bhutale. You speak, na? You speak? Not speak? Not speaking? Do you understand this point? Si chaitanya manavhishta sthapitam jena bhutale. Do you understand? You know the meaning of this Sanskrit word? Sri Chaitanya Manavistamadha, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to do, his parshad, it matters little whether they are coming earlier or a later, come with him or before, or with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or after, it matters little. Because Narottama Thakur came much later, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not there in this material world. What do you mean by parshad? Narottama Thakur, eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Though he came late, he couldn't meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, still parshad. Prabhupada, eternal parshad of Radharani, eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Bhaktivinod Thakur also. This way, eternal parshad means who can establish the Siddhanta and the, you know, planning of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what want to do. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to get it done by some devotee. It is the nature of Prabhu, it is the nature of Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. He want to get it done by somebody. It is the nature of Prabhu. Sampradaya Pravartam to inculcate bhakti. It is the duty of bhakta, those who are devotee. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that's why he came in the form of devotee. Actually, Supreme Lord. He came just like a devotee. That's why it was possible for him. He did. Now, point is that Prabhupada wanted to preach the Chaitanya Vani all over the world. I told yesterday that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was the first person. He was the first person who started preaching Gauranga Vani. Hey, yeah! He was the first person, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was the first person who started preaching Chaitanya Vani in different language. Hindi, English, Bengali, Urdu, Sanskrit. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was so learned man. He was the first person to speak in front of all educated people, in front of all foreign devotees. He was the pioneer. He was the first person. After that, Prabhupada and all our Guru Varga. Srila Goswami Maharaj's first series of preacher. If you make a branch of preacher, he was the first, you know, number one preacher. So much humble attitude, at the same time, so much detachment. You cannot expect that kind of detachment, I mean, vairagya. You see, externally you can find that he was married, but after that, but still what? Those who are Mayavadi, they were passing this kind of rumor. That he is married, so no possibility of getting bhakti. They are actually Mayavadi. Ex-mission. You understand my point, what I mean to say? Ex-mission, why mission they are passing this kind of... Oh, he touched woman. That means he is not going to... They are actually idiot. I would say they are idiot number one. Bhakti is not a matter of joke. Bhakti is so unique thing. Bhakti is a function of your soul. Bhakti is the natural function of your soul, which is expressed through your external organs. Hand, leg, eyes. Bhakti is expressed. But bhakti is the natural function of your soul. So it's not a matter, he is married, he is not married. It's not a matter, they are actually Mayavadi. They are actually Mayavadi, they speak like that. Married, so what? So what? Srinivasa is married, so many, I mean, Sarva Bhattacharya married, they all married. So what? They are getting bhakti, full kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It's not a matter. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu repeatedly told, Bhaktivinod Thakur wanted to represent this thing, wherever you stay, in what situation you are put into, that's not a matter. What kind of sankirtan you are doing, pure sankirtan, out of your pure devotion, that's first point. Grihe thako, bane thako, sada hari bole thako. Bhakti Mehta bole dako. Bhakti Mehta speaking. This is the gist of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It's not speaking morning time you can sing about, you can chant Harinam, noon time not, you can go and do all rubbish thing. Not. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, all the time you will have to sing. Uninterrupted way. Those who are pure devotee, there's no interruption in their Harinam, Harikirtan, and there is no breakage of any linkage. Their linkage is permanent. Maybe they are in coma state or in what situation, there is not matter. Or each and every, that is called Siddha Mahatma. Anywhere they stay, only linkage is all and no breakage of any linkage. First point. Be careful, those Mayavadi, if you are running here and there like mad, you cannot get pure association. And as per Gauriya Siddhanta, it is written, Rupa Goswami was speaking, Svajati rasvaya snigde sadhu sango sato vare. If you go like here and there, if you move, you can lose your bhakti. Like-minded people you cannot get. That translation is not perfect, I think. It is in Chaitanya Charita, in Rasamrita Sindhu by Rupa Goswami Pad, Svajati rasvaya snigde sadhu sango sato vare. If you can get that kind of sadhu, who is there in your sampradaya but elevated, having so much treasure in his heart, that kind of sadhu, that kind of association is expected. We are willing to that kind. But if you go running here and there, maybe who can say? You are meeting with some madman who like to prove that I am a big devotee. But you have no experience, you cannot understand, he is not. You are going to be cheated. Yesterday, that's what I told. So all, most of Guru, our Chaitanya Parshad, they are all married, so what problem? They are doing all bhakti, nicely, well. At present, you can make so much society, you can make so much rules and regulation, you can make a secretary, you can make a president, no matter. But still, you are not able to control the society smoothly. What's the reason behind it? Why? Because your goal is different. His goal is different. His goal is different. All devotees coming here in one place, they have their separate interest. They have their separate interest. If you have separate interest, and if he has separate interest, if he is having separate interest, then collusion, sangharsha is a must. Like I told you repeatedly, Paramahansa Siddhartha Goswami also used to give the same example. If you can make one single point and draw different kind of countless circle, with different radius this, make slight radius, 0.0 millimeter less. This way you can draw countless circles. No circle cutting other circle, because their center point is same. But if 0.001 millimeter, if you center point is just displaced, 0.001 millimeter, then you can see, if you like to draw one circle, it can cut with other circle. There's a collusion problem. Any kind of personal efforts, endeavor, is not sufficient to get bhakti. That's why you are coming here to get bhakti from Maharaj. not to get money, not to get nice prasadam, so that we can come 1 o'clock, that time prasadam distribution time is 1 o'clock. We can go that time, we need prasadam and money. That is the present situation. I am laughing, sometimes crying, to see this present situation, I am crying. Feminine of bhakti, feminine of harikatha, durvikha. Feminine of harikatha, feminine of, you see, bhakti. This is the situation at present. So you see, what I wanted to say, just before, one minute before. Then center point is disturbed. Displaced, then it can cut. This way, each and everywhere in this material planet, no spiritual organization is just saved from this kind of altercation of fighting. You cannot find one single place. Mayadevi is so strong. Mayadevi is going to give one spell, magical spell. So everybody hypnotized. They are running behind money, woman, position, rank. So how you can expect to get bhakti? Not possible. But you remember, you can go through Chaitanya Bhagavata Chaitanya Charitamrita. That time it is there that thousands of devotees, they came to sacrifice their life for the cause of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Everybody came. Thousands of devotees, maybe lakhs of devotees came. They came to dedicate their life unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They had no kind of separate interest. In this situation, one kind of automatic harmonization. In this situation, when your dedication is 100% perfect, when you like to dedicate your life unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or to lotus feet of Gurupad Padmo, then you can get, automatically you can get adjusted, harmonized. Guru Mukha Padma Bhatyo Hidayate Koriya Ikya Arna Koriya Manyasa. That is the main point. So I am explaining this point. Guru Mukha Padma Kyo, what you are hearing from Gurudev, your heart should be totally harmonized with your Guru Padma. Otherwise, 100% you are going to fail. You are a failure. 100% you are going to fail. Your heart should be 100% harmonized with Guru Padma. So Rupa Goswami Pad, Sonatan Goswami Pad, they are staying thousands of miles away. Sometimes 1,000 miles, or maybe more than thousands of miles, or hundreds of miles away from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Still, their heart is totally harmonized with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So it is not a matter. It matters little. Wherever they are staying, they are going to implement to the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu anyway. Srila Goswami Maharaj, sometimes staying in America, sometimes in UK, in England, sometimes in German, in France, it's not a matter of joke. Bhano Goswami Maharaj also. Whenever they have some sort of doubt, then automatically Prabhupada solving everything. Prabhupada staying in Dham, but still from here, Prabhupada can solve all problems that is happening there, in England or in America or in Germany, it's not matter. From here, Prabhupada can understand, solving everything. This is called Guru Sishya. If I have my relation with my Guru Padma, then be sure Guru Maharaj can protect me each and every time. You cannot put me in trouble. You cannot stop my Harikatha. Maybe some jealousy is there, they can like to stop my Harikatha, they like to fight with me, because I am less interested about my position and money and situation. No. Guru. That is the situation. So you see, at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all devotees coming unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are totally dedicated unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's why there is no problem. They are automatically harmonized with each other. They are doing sankirtan in a very enthusiastic way, very nice way, gigantic way of spreading this procedure, sankirtan. Now today you have no man, single man you cannot point out who can do sankirtan at the appearance day of Prabhupada. You are hiring people from outside to do sankirtan and take prasadam and go away. No harikatha. We don't need harikatha at present. We are so idiot, so foolish. We don't need harikatha. We need money, position, and this much we know. Tibikam Maharaj, you know Tibikam Maharaj used to stay with Srila Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj and my Guru Maharaj together. I think you know him, Tibikam Maharaj, or gone today. Tibikam Maharaj used to stay in a Dakai language. In Dhaka, they are speaking some crude language. In Dhaka, they are speaking some crude language, speaking, usually. Suare senekosu, abandara senekola. You know what I mean to say? Monkey understand only banana. And those pig, on the stool, nice stool and kachu, one kind of growing from, it's useless. Tibikumar used to speak in Dakai language, very crude language. Monkey always interested about banana and this, that is very sufficient. If you want to give one very nice or precious jewel, monkey can say, what I can do with this precious jewel? Useless. He can throw. Huh? It is valuable to you, not for monkey. This way, you see, everybody we are interested with some useless thing. Whereas in Rasamrita Sindhu, Brihad Bhagavatam, everywhere, man, come on, you will have to get preparation. Your life is very short. You are wasting your life. You see the vivid example of Srila Goswami Maharaj. You see the vivid example of Srila Goswami Maharaj. If you cannot see one vivid example in front of you. He is so nice, gigantic personality doing bhakti. Until and unless you cannot get that kind of illustrated example, illustrated sadhu, you cannot get power. Powerful sadhu is there, then you can get. You can see Bhakti Vala Thittu Goswami Maharaj doing sankirtan. Amare ki niya loho bhajo gauro hori. Everybody we are dancing. But now, who is going to dance? Who is going to cry? Where is that Santo Goswami Maharaj? Gone. During the time of Gundicha Mandar, everybody is shedding tears. Oh, so nice, ecstatic feeling. Doing Gundicha Mandar, vikirtan, sankirtan. But now you cannot get. You can spend money to come from England or America, Russia, billions of dollars you can spend, still you are not going to get one drop of bhakti which can change your whole life. Bhakti is a nectar. Srila Maharaj went to foreign country by the inspiration of Prabhupada. They are speaking Harikatha in front of all important people, in front of Queen Elizabeth, this, that, speaking. They say, we don't have time to hear all about your philosophy. Well, we are not going to represent some philosophy. If you, oh, only, okay, only 10 minutes we can give you. Oh, half an hour. Or cross the table, dinner table. Cross the dinner table, we have no separate time. You can sit, we can eat, we can take meal, midday meal, and you can speak Harikatha. That much time we can provide for you. Okay, that's okay. Then he is sitting across the table, they are eating and he is speaking Harikatha. 2 hours gone, they cannot calculate, they forget to see, watch. So nice Harikatha, they are bumper success. This way Srila Goswami Maharaj is successful everywhere. Who is enjoying Guru Kippa, he is successful everywhere. who is enjoying Guru Kripa, he can come out successful everywhere. Not that here, here is successful, not there, not that big. Actually, his preaching procedure was very, very nice. So nice. And later, he was made actually Sampadak, editor. Sampadak of Gaudiya. Gaudiya Patrika magazine, he was, Sampadak. So big Pandit. You cannot expect that kind of English from an Oxford bachelor. At the same time, he was expert in Sanskrit, in Hindi, Bengali. So one preacher should have that kind of quality. We should follow Srila Goswami Maharaj. He is going in front of king. He is speaking in front of pretty lady. So nice lady coming. Beautiful ladies. So what? One Siddha Mahatma never speak outer design. He sees lady, he is Jain, sees lady, not speak. They only speak the spirit there inside body. Outside design and sees ladies, so you are feeling attraction. That kind of feeling is not there inside actual preacher like Maharaj. A symptom of actual preacher is that he can cut and everything. If there is one anything against bhakti, he can cut everything. And establish bhakti there. That kind of big devotee, Nitya Parshad. Nitya Parshad means who is going to implement the heart of Prabhupada. So you can say he is Nitya Parshad. Those who are all taking Diksha and Harinam from Prabhupada, they are not all Nitya Parshad. This Siddhanta, you must speak in front of all foreign devotees, they are all foolish. Not that those who are getting Harinam and Diksha from Prabhupada, they are all Parshad, not that. Foolish. Yesterday I was speaking one slope. Paramhansa varam paramatha patim. Are you speaking? Patita dharane kito vesha jatim. Jati rajagonai parisheva padam. Pranamami sada prabhupadu padam. Pranamami sada prabhupadu padam. Pranamami sada prabhupadu padam. What does it mean? Those who are taking Diksha from Prabhupada, they are not all eternal persons of Prabhupada. Otherwise, why we find Patito Dharan Ekkito Vesajitim? He is Paramahansa Param, he is topmost Paramahansa, but still, having externally, he is having sannyas base with danda, tidanda. He wanted to deliver our fallen soul. Patito Dharan Ekkito Vesajitim? All fallen soul was delivered, all fallen soul. So if there is no fallen soul, why should, no need of coming here? Why should Prabhupada come? Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur? If there is no fallen soul? Fallen soul is there, to deliver them he came here. This is a Siddhanta. So not that all devotees, they came in front of Prabhupada, they took Harinam and Diksha, that doesn't mean they are eternal Parsad of Prabhupada. That's why Prabhupada many times told, if the whole world going to reject me, if the whole world going to reject me, those coming to me, I mean as disciple, those who are coming to me, if one by one they all like to leave me in my life, still I don't care. Prabhupada told many times, if the whole world going to reject me, my speech and me, if they like to reject the whole world, if they want to reject me, if one by one they all going away from me, those who came to me as my disciple, one by one if they take decision to go away from me because my Siddhanta is so pure, so hard, they are not eligible to digest it. If one advice you are getting from Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, so many advice, so many harikatha, but if you cannot digest, what use? You should digest. So this way, Prabhupada speaking, still, I am standing under the lotus feet of my Guru Padma Paramahansa, and I am not going to leave speaking the absolute about absolute truth. I can speak all about the absolute truth. I am speaking all about absolute. I cannot speak what our boneless soul they like to hear from me. I am not going to speak. They like to get some position, rank, everything. I told you just now, at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are automatically adjusted, harmonized, because they are single goal. With single motive and goal they came to dedicate their life unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's why there is no fighting, nothing. But now so many fighting. So time is very limited. I wanted to speak so much, but time is limited. So I like to stop. One chakalpa durvasi ke pasindu bevajapati tanang pavane pavishna bhyo namo.